my father was also involved in the war as well. He was son of a man who was put in Starobel's labor camp, and he himself, when I asked him what school I should send my son to, pointed out that he'd become a professor despite the fact that his secondary schooling consisted of 6 weeks in a Trans-Siberian Railway School. And I've always, therefore, when I've been asked whether I bemoan the fact that Britain doesn't have big ideas, responded that I'm quite suspicious of them, because the big ideas drove my family out of their house, they murdered my grandmother, they stole our property, they robbed my parents of their country, they had to then rebuild their lives as immigrants in a foreign land, in a language they didn't speak, and bring up their children there. So I quite like the small things about Britain, the suburbs, the much-hated bourgeoisie, television sitcoms on the BBC. My grandmother always used to say that while the Queen is safe in Buckingham Palace, we're safe in Hendon Central. And that is a small summary of my politics. I think there's an awful lot to be said for British stability, for the quiet rule of law and order, for lack of hysteria, for moderation, for pragmatism. And all those things are almost as important in my politics as any specific idea or set of ideas.